What's going on, YouTube? Today we have another special day. Someone from the card community, a fellow YouTuber who does an awesome job, also the creator of the new FRL League. If you're not sure what that is, you should definitely check it out. I'll have a link to his channel. Right now, I think he's got like 320 subs, but I'm going to have his information right here. I'll also have it below. You should definitely check him out. He's always ripping something fun, and he does hit some bangers. So you guys should check his channel out. Like I said, he's also the creator of this FRL League, which I think is absolutely genius. It's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to make the football season and ripping product a whole lot of fun. I think everybody's going to end up wanting to do it just because if you like fantasy football or fantasy sports in general, and you love, you know, ripping product, ripping, you know, packs, and trying to find your favorite players and add to your PC. This is just combining those elements, and I think it's genius. But anyways, we got a package from him. I'm excited to see what he sent. This is actually a really large package, so I'm kind of curious as to what he had actually put in here. This is like a big box of cards. So let's see, make sure there's no information on the inside as well. Okay, cool. So, where do we open the front here? I just wanted to say thank you. Ethan is his name. You guys definitely should check him out. Subscribe if you're not already. I imagine a lot of you are just because he's such a cool guy. Definitely hilarious. I actually highlighted him a couple months ago now. If you guys wanted to see that video as well. In top 11 YouTubers I think you guys should follow in the community. He was one in there just because I think he's got a good sense of humor and he loves cards. He's always ripping the latest product. Like recently, right now, he's got some Chronicles, and obviously that's the hottest thing on the market right now if you guys are interested in that. Holy crap, okay. We've got very nice packaging. Looks like we got two large packs of cards. If you guys don't know already, which I'm assuming that you do, I am a Cleveland sports fan, diehard, been a fan my entire life. How can I get inside this thing? Here we go. We got tons of packs. Okay, this is going to be a little bit longer. As you know, I like to take my time when I go through cards. Let me set this up a little bit so that, make sure, there we go, get all the dust stuff out of here. Right on the front we see KPJ, Kevin Porter Jr. I think he's going to be really good. Can I open this? There we go. Keep the team bags as well. So Kevin Porter Jr. from Mosaic. Like I said, I think he's going to be great. This isn't just my opinion. I think I've heard this from quite a few collectors, people in the space, that they really believe. I'm actually interested to see what Cleveland does with him because we got so many good young guards now. But stoked about his future. Now, this is a sexy card. He's in the Cavs uniform. As you guys know, I just, in a previous video, bought this, but I'm trying to collect as many LeBrons now as I can. I do have some, obviously, in his Lakers uniform. I actually don't think I have very many in his Miami uniform because I was kind of bitter back then about him, but winter stays, that's a cool one. Is this Ozzie Newsome? I think it is. Yeah, Ozzie. Check out Ozzie, and this is 72 out of 99. Ozzie, man. I just recently was able to get an autograph of his. I was stoked about that. Really good tight end. He's the guy that ended up going into management with the Browns and eventually the Ravens. But then we got a cool one here. We got a Von Bell from our Ohio State Buckeyes. No, I'm actually wearing my Ohio State hat right now. Big Ohio State fan as well. This is like my team that actually does get the win. Besides the one championship LeBron bought. Broughton. Ohio State University, Von Bell. What year is this? Let's say 2016. It's hard to see. Yeah, I think so. Really cool. Really cool signature. Put that up top for now. This is our guy right here. This is my quarterback.
This is my team. This is my quarterback.
If you guys don't know, I'm a huge Browns fan. I believe in Baker. I know that last year he had like a mediocre year, which was still wasn't like a terrible year. I think it's getting blown out of proportion, you know. Obviously, with the talent, they thought that the team was going to do a lot more, and I obviously thought we were going to do a lot more. But, man, this year I think we're primed and ready. He's doing so many less commercials. He's not seen anywhere. But, you know, it was right for him to probably be in all of those commercials before because the guy broke the rookie record for touchdowns. He threw 27 in his rookie year in, I think, 14 games or something like that. So, yeah. All right, now we got some baseball. We got Mr. Bradley. I talked about him in a previous one. Once he gets his bat going, because like when he was in spring training, he was hitting a lot of home runs like last year before, and he just didn't equate up. See, he did. It's here, minor league. See, he had 33. Look at that guy. He's huge, too. He's like 6'1", 6'2". Big bat. So I think he's going to have a bright future. Then we got Mr. Savale, which actually pitched yesterday. By the time you see this, it won't be yesterday. He got himself a win, but he had a tough outing. I think our pitching staff is ridiculous, and he's one of the reasons why. This is a beautiful card, too. What is this? Chrome refractor. Somebody knocked on the door real quick. I think I just got something dropped off from Amazon. Mr. Kluber and Trevor Bauer. These are two guys that are no longer on the squad, but really good pitchers. Actually, I think at the time of this recording, Trevor Bauer might be leading the entire majors in ERA right now. That's how good he was. But he has a short temper. And if you guys don't know, I'll put a link right, or I'll probably have a cutaway. But the guy gets taken out of the game and decides to throw the ball. If you guys obviously follow baseball at all, and you've seen it, just tosses the ball over the center field fence.
Well, Trevor Bauer, when he was taken out of the game, turned and I don't know where he threw that ball.
Well, I don't know.
Just a bit outside. He tried the corner and missed.
And now he's actually doing YouTube videos. He's actually trying to document the bubble. If you guys haven't seen those, you should check those out. So, and this one guy here is a legend. If you guys don't know anything about Bob Feller, he was like the original rocket. He was the original arm. They said that he was able to throw over 100 miles an hour, 105 or something like that. There's some old footage, and maybe I'll put that in here as well, of him like them actually making contraptions just to catch the speed of his pitches. Like the first like speed guns and stuff were brought out for, I think, him, Bob Feller. And there's other things like him like throwing it faster than a motorcycle that was like speeding by. It's pretty cool.
The siege gun of the baseball world, Bob Feller, pitcher for the Cleveland Indians, takes time off in the nation's capital to demonstrate his cannonball delivery. It is recorded by the Army Ordnance Department's Lumaline chronograph, installed in the framework between Feller and the catcher. The setup was designed to test the velocity of shells during the war.
That's the one that opens the bullseye. I guess we're all set. Here's the test that shows which is the faster, the racing motorcycle or the pitched ball. Coming down the highway at a speed of 86 miles per hour, the policeman crosses the pitching line, and there they go. Bingo! Too fast for you?
Next we got Oscar Gonzalez. First Bowman? Cool. First Bowman. That's from this year, 2020. I actually still have not been able to buy any Bowman or anything else. I'm hoping to actually get some Chrome. I'd really like to open some Chrome and some Bowman, to be honest. Then we got, where did I put the rookie right there? Mrs. Glace, another rookie. I actually like this set, this Gypsy Queen. I've opened like one blaster box of it. I kind of liked it. I don't know. It's different. It's like, it reminds me of, I don't know. It says Gypsy Queen. I guess it reminds you of gypsies, you know, like something you would buy out of like that machine that you see in the, what is it? That Tom Hanks, that old Tom Hanks, the kid. Is it called the kid? I can't remember. Somebody's going to correct me. We got Yu Chang and another Bobby Bradley. Two more rookie cards out of Diamond Kings. Bright futures for both of these kids. So once we lose Lindor in a year, I'm excited to see where that goes. I'll try and speed this up a little bit, but I like taking my time when I'm going through this. Just want to say again that I'm thankful for the gift. And like I said, I'm going to say it again. Guys need to go follow these guys. They're a lot of fun. They really help the community and build the community up. Like I said, he's created a game that's going to, I think, make the community even stronger. So definitely go and show your support. He's awesome. Here we got a Seti Osman. Seti Osman, I always thought had a really good future. It doesn't seem like he gets the playing time anymore like he should. But he's really good. He's a really good young talent. And then we got Dylan Windler, rookie. This is a rated rookie from Optic from this year. And we got another KPJ. This one's the Optic one. That's a sexy one. We got another Dylan Windler in the, Blue Vortex Prism, I want to say. That's a really nice card. I like the Blue Vortexes. Looks nice. We got Mr. TT, Tristan Thompson. I'll show this clip again. I love it. And this is like him. Apparently, there's a rumor that he was just trying to do anything to get out of Cleveland. It's just a meme. But I'll show that clip because I think it's hilarious.
Simmons tipped it. Thompson recoups it. Now Simmons, a smart play here because Thompson is forced to handle with the shot clock running down. There's Thompson wildly throwing it up. Well done by...
And now that you're back, we'll go into Mr. Colin Sexton. I like the throwback unis and stuff. I've seen a couple of these now with the throwback unis. But this is a sweet prism as well. These are going to go right into the PC. Wow. Okay, I think I've seen a couple of these. I might have like the jaw of this arriving now. Darius Garland, that's a cool one. I like that. Where's he at? Like a subway system there? Is that a subway? I'm not sure what's going on there. Then we got Mr. Kevin Love. I've talked about this before. Kevin Love is an absolute animal. And you guys should just check out his stats before he came. I mean, even when he came to the Cavs, he was still doing like 19 and 11 or something like that. But before we got him, you know, like he weighed probably 40 pounds more and was just an animal. He had like a 40-20 game, 30-30 game, a couple 40-20 games. That's 40 points, 20 boards, 30 points, 30 boards. I might say it's like just him and Dwight Howard might be the only ones with 30-30 games in the last like 20 years. I could be wrong, but someone could fact check me on that. But that's how good he is. Doesn't get the support or the love that he should. All right, now we got another Aaron Civale, rookie refractor from Bowman Chrome. That's a cool one. Like, what is this, like a rainbow, maybe? I don't know. That's a cool one, though. I like that. That rookie of the year favorites. That's a nice one. Where did I put him? Put him here. Here we go. We got Greedy Williams, and this is actually 23 out of 71. I know it's hard to see because it's in the same red. But Greedy, I think, is going to come back this year and do really well for us. He's a DB. Sorry if you guys can hear those guys. What? Holy crap, dude. We got ourselves a Bernie Kosar autograph. 9 out of 30. Whoa. Man, this is sick.
Tell him to bring me my money.
Yeah! Oh my gosh. Dude, that is awesome. Let me set this up here real quick. I need to highlight my Bernie Kosar. This is awesome. Obviously, guys, if you don't know who Bernie is, he was a part of, like, the Cardiac Kids in the 90s and stuff, 80s and 90s. Well, he probably came a little bit. Yeah, he's right in there. Beloved. Let's see if I can get him in frame. We'll put our other autograph up there as well. Mr. Von Bell on the opposite side. That is a sick autograph, man. Thank you so much for that. That's just awesome. What is this? This is cool. This looks like a ID or something. Baker Mayfield NFL passport. This might be this is a rookie as well. This is sick, man. I do not have these cards. Most of these, I have like maybe one or two of these cards that you've sent me, by the way. Dude, this is an awesome one. This is a great freaking mail day. I like that card a lot too. I'm going to put that one up top. It's our quarterbacks right there. He's going to take us to the promised land. And it looks like we got another one right on top. Old Baker. I'm telling you guys. I know you guys have seen it a million times on my channel now because I've probably bought 1,000 Bakers. I think I just think this year's the year. All right, so we got some Joey Bosa and Nick Bosa, if you guys can see. Both played for Ohio State University. Both pretty dominant. Our Nick Bosas, our Bosas. Then we got Nick Chubb. I think he should have won the title last year, rushing title, if our team was. I mean, obviously we were playing meaningless game, and Titans weren't, but he should have won. He's the rushing champ, man. I love Nick. I love him, man. I think he's a sick running back. Then we got a couple Bakers up top. We got MVP contenders. And another contender's season ticket. I don't think I have these at all. So I haven't had like very many, like, you know, I'm just coming back. Most of the cards I have, I've actually purchased, you know. So these are cool ones. Put this with that Baker. We got Mr. Antonio Callaway. Everybody thought he was going to do something. But, you know, so you can't win them all. Mr. Antonio Callaway there. Then we got Zeke for the Ohio State University, also with Terry and Nick Bosa. Actually, there's a lot of Ohio State players coming up. Ohio State, man, especially this year, just full of talent, you know, obviously full of talent. We had so many people in the draft this year that was just nuts. But, man, this is a sick-looking card. Prism of some sort. From 2020. Maybe like draft picks or something. Cool. Zeke obviously was an animal. I think Dobbins is going to be crazy. I hate that he went to the Ravens. We got Terry. Scary Terry. I think he's going to continue to do big things. Especially with Hoskins. We got another Nick Bosa. Is this a Prism of some sort? Yeah, Prism. Dude, this is a sweet card. With the red on the red. That looks nice. And then the black for the Ohio State there. And you even got the scarlet. The gray right there. That's nice. That's a beautiful card right there. And this one's the same. This is a nice parallel. Really works well with the team. I don't know if they're all like this or if maybe it's just a red parallel of some sort. It'd be cool if they're like all team colors, but then it looks really nice. KJ Hill, he went this year. Got Mr. Michael Thomas, the leading wide receivers in a, receptions in a season now. This one's a blue prism. The red works nice there too, red and blue. It's from 2020 draft picks, so just a different parallel. Running out of time, so I'll go a little faster. Got Nick Chubb, obviously Nick Chubb from Georgia. I think Sony Michel was also on that team. Before them was Todd Gurley. So they've had quite a few really good running backs come out of Georgia. I love this one with the orange, though. Put this one in this orange parallel. Actually, both of these because they're like Browns colors. Both from the same year, 2020. Yeah. This is a cool one. Really like that. Don't have any of these cards, man. Seriously, this is awesome. Got another Scary Terry. Yeah, I've got a minute and a half before this shuts off, so we'll go fast. Terry McLaurin. We got another Zeke. Another cool Baker. We got Grant Delpit. A couple of Delpits now. And Donovan Peoples-Jones coming up from the school up north, Prism. I'm excited to see what he does. Same with Delpit. I think Delpit's going to be huge for us. A couple more Bakers to end it. Look at this, Rookies and Stars. Honestly, man, I don't have any of these. I don't even know. This is an amazing gift, dude. Thank you so much. And we got Miles and Odell here. I think Odell's going to have another season. He's going to be healthier. Miles Garrett got that huge deal, dude. I'm expecting him to lead this. I want to see how many sacks this guy gets. Full season, I'm saying he's getting 15 sacks this year, maybe more. That's my number. All right, so many cards to look at, so many highlights. I'm just going to end up showing you this one real quick. I'm going to end it with this one on screen. Bernie Kosar, guys, look at him. This is an awesome card, awesome gift. Again, check him out. Information is going to be right here below. Video, link to his channel, stuff's going to be below. You guys really should go support him. Thank you so much again, Ethan, for this gift. It's ridiculous. I love it. Love it. So you guys, definitely go support him. Help him get to 500 subs. I want to see him get up to 500 subs, you know, by the end of next month. All right, guys. I'll see you guys in the next video.